Long before time had a name, Ninjago was created using the four golden weapons forged in the Temple of Light: the Scythe of Quakes, the Nunchucks of Lightning, the Shurikens of Ice, and the Sword of Fire. Weapons so powerful, nobody could handle all their power at once. But the land would also give birth to a dark presence rising from the shadows, the Overlord. To combat the first Benjutsu Master, the Overlord created the Stone Army, an indestructible force to help him win the battle against the golden power of his light counterpart. The battle was intense, and the darkness seemed to be coming out on top. So, to prevent losing both the war and the land, the first Benjutsu Master divided the land into two sections, Ninjago itself and the Dark Island. The Overlord was banished to said Dark Island, and the Stone Army was buried in the tomb deep within the land, but the battle would still remain unfinished for some time. Following the chaos, the first Benjutsu Master created the Realm Crystal, and the first traces of life appeared in the land of Ninjago, including the Serpentine Race. Together with early humans and elemental masters, they colonized the land and began to revolutionize. To further represent the balance of the land, the first Benjutsu Master created two sons. Garmadon, the eldest, was given the element of destruction, and Wu, the younger brother, was given the power of creation. Wu and Garmadon would grow up to be the best of friends, until one unfortunate day. During a brief training session, Wu's katana flew over the walls of his father's monastery. Looking out for his younger brother, Garmadon went over to retrieve it, but he would soon encounter the Great Devourer, and was actually bitten by the legendary evil snake. Its venom would soon begin to corrupt him, but it would take years for the evil to fully take over his mind. The first Benjutsu Master evidently passed away, but left his staff for a young Master Wu, which also held a message containing the location of his final resting place. In another part of the world, two rival fleets of pirates stationed on the Destiny's Bounty and the Misfortune's Keep respectively, fought it out on the high seas. Eventually though, Captain Soto of the Destiny's Bounty managed to capture the opposing leader Nauticon in an ancient teapot and trap the other crew members in various realms. Soto then continued to search for the Island of Darkness, but the Destiny's Bounty eventually turned to a wreck, killing everyone on board. Years later, a young Dr. Julian built an android. He raised him to be his son and cherished him up to his final days. Meanwhile, Garmadon makes the decision to leave the monastery and his brother Wu to train under Master Chen, with a fellow student that went by the name of Klaus. At the same time, Wu proceeded to train a young Master of Wind who could potentially turn out to be the prophesized Green Ninja. This young warrior was named Moro, and after the Golden Weapons denied his destiny, he set out to prove Wu and the weapons wrong, but he was eventually killed in the Caves of Despair, and his spirit was transferred to the Cursed Realm for his actions. The Serpentine-originated prophecy of the Golden Master started to cause paranoia between the Serpentine kind and the locals of Ninjago, and with Master Chen putting both sides against each other, the First Serpentine War broke out. The evil had not yet fully taken over Garmadon's body, and he came to his senses and joined his brother along with other elemental masters to fight against the Serpentine. Little did they know, Chen was also causing betrayals within the Alliance itself, and driving the Serpentine closer and closer to victory. But with the discovery of sacred flutes, the Alliance managed to cripple the Serpentine forces, lock them in tombs, banish Chen and Klaus to a secluded island, and have the Anachondri generals banished to the Cursed Realm. After their victory, the Alliance celebrated, but the feeling would be short-lived. Acronix and Crux, the elemental masters of time, were convinced that their power was superior to others, so they betrayed the Alliance with the intent on ruling Ninjago. Knowing what may come from the Time Twins' ignorance, Master Wu had Rei and Maya, the elemental masters of fire and water, create four blades capable of absorbing elemental powers. Wu and Garmadon used these blades to strip Acronix and Crux of their powers and also managed to create a temporal vortex, in which the blades were sent. The Time Twins were not about to be defeated, so they ventured into the vortex after them, trapping themselves in time. While Acronix may have been lost, Crux reappeared along with the reversal time blade. Crux was unaware that the blade had followed him, and Rei and Maya placed it within the boiling sea for safekeeping. At this point, Garmadon settled down and married his longtime friend and now wife, Misako. A few major births happened within the next upcoming years, spawning new incarnations of the elements of fire, water, earth, and lightning. Garmadon and Misako would also give birth to a young boy, whom they named Lloyd. Rei and Maya were enjoying their time at the blacksmith shop with their children and their new friend, Dr. Sanders Saunders. However, the doctor revealed himself to be Crux after all and threatened the lives of their children and abducted Rei and Maya, leading everyone, including their children, to believe that they were dead. A few years later, the evil flowing through Garmadon's system finally completely possessed him. At the monastery, he tried to steal and wield the golden weapons to turn the land of Ninjago into his own image, and Wu prepared to hold the final stand. A duel broke out, each son of the first Ninjutsu Master armed with two golden weapons, but Garmadon got the upper hand. Garmadon prepared to kill his longtime friend and brother, but the symbols on Wu's kimono prevented this and opened a gateway to the underworld. Garmadon was struck by lightning, altering his appearance, and was cast down to spend the rest of eternity living in the shadows. Peace returned to the land, but Wu sensed that one day Lord Garmadon would return, so he took the four golden weapons and hid them throughout the land, placing a dragon guardian to protect each, but he knew it wasn't enough. Years later, he enlisted three young men and eventually contracted a fourth to help him protect the golden weapons. He trained them in the arts of stealth and, of course, taught them the ways of Spinjitzu. This was, of course, preparing them for Garmadon's eventual return. Garmadon's son also joined the fight as the prophesized Green Ninja, and together the team faced many threats to the land and always stood up for greatness. They've experienced the power of the first Spinjitzu Master, and throughout their many struggles, they have never given up, because, of course, a ninja never quits.